What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. At our next service call, customer's complaint, the central air conditioning is not cooling, but the system is running. I don't hear a compressor. Wow, inch and an eighth line set. And it's only, is it 4 ton? How many tons is this bad boy? Five. 5 ton system here, R410A, Baruch Hashem. Manufacture date of May 2012. I don't hear compressor.
What do you notice?
All right, so if we ain't testing, we're guessing. All right, let's see Derek in action. We got Derek, first year HVAC apprentice, Daniel, seasoned senior HVAC technician, and you have moi, Mikey effing Pipes. He's pulling out the disconnect the correct way. That is good. He's gonna use a 5/16 driver on the drill, taking out the screws for the access panel. Your mileage may vary. You may have a 1/4 inch screw there securing that cover.
What was right on the cover?
No, just mold. It's moldy. Let's see what we have in the access panel. We got...
It's on voltage. Yeah, how you use
it? Yeah, it's on voltage.
We got, looks like a soft starter there. We have a capacitors.
It's going to have power because the fan was running now.
Yeah. Got that soft starter. I got money on the soft starter.
You think so?
What do you think?
I think capacitor.
I think there's no refrigerant in the system.
That's also possible.
I'm doing him a solid.
Other ends, the outside ends. Yeah, right there.
He's checking for voltage.
It's
got 245 volts. So, Derek, just so you know, the fan was running. Yeah. Right? So we're going to have voltage. Process of elimination. So the first thing you're going to do is take a visual observation of everything. Make sure nothing is out of the ordinary. We have 2 capacitors, we have a contactor, we have a soft start. And the system was running, but it wasn't cooling. What would you do next, Derek?
First, I'm gonna check the capacitor.
Okay, why don't you discharge it first? Discharge the capacitor.
Too late.
Discharge the capacitor. Does he know how to discharge a capacitor?
I don't know if I've ever told him to discharge it.
Here, watch. You wanna take insulated something and touch things together, right? So if there's any charge between the terminals, it's gonna short out. Okay, now you can pull off your things. Make sure you know where the wires went. I'm not gonna spend an hour trying to figure out what went where.
You gotta show them about leverage too.
Yeah.
All about leverage, Derek. It's all about the leverage. Leverage is your friend. You know what I mean by that?
Use the edge of the capacitor as a lever.
Should mean like this?
Yeah, and then push down on the tool and it'll pull up for you. Kinda.
So now watch this, look. So this the orange one's already off. So like the red one right there, right? The tool is against that. Look at that, see that? The tool's against
it's
the...
Like prying it off.
Exactly, but you're using this as a fulcrum. Or as the axis. I think fulcrum was correct. So you're gonna test the capacitor. Let's set that to read microfarads. One of the questions I asked him on a practical exam during the interview process was, does he know how to test a capacitor? Unfortunately, he didn't know, but now he does. Hopefully. No. No.
Where's common?
There's common is both, either or. It's a single capacitor. No, you have to go with the other set of terminals.
Let's sit there for a minute. 54. What's it rated for?
What is it rated?
55.
It says 80.
Ooh.
No. Yeah.
Is it 80?
Yeah. It's
80. Take that screw out. Let's see what it is.
Just make sure no metal touches the contactor. 24 volts.
Yeah, we don't want to replace fuses. You may need a 5/16 driver because it's too thick against it.
Yeah, look.
Ooh, that's hot, by the way. Yeah, it's a hot capacitor. Just like your mom. Oh! That capacitor is blazing hot, by the way.
Is it?
Yeah, yeah. I bet your stuff is boiling inside there.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah. We got a boiler, mama. We may need the cool presser. Remember, don't let that capacitor touch the contactor. You're gonna short out the fuse.
Wow.
Wow. It's an 80.
Did you put the soft start in?
Yes. That is boiling hot. Well, we're putting in an 80, but does it really need an 80 is the question. Can we see?
Is the capacitor readable or compressing?
Almost. Almost. Where is it? Cat. What does that say?
80, 370.
No. Where do you see 80?
Run, cat.
80, 370. Yep. 80, 370. Bluefin. Keep telling Daniel to stop buying the garbage. No. Pay attention to what you're doing.
I'm on call.
80. Good.
All right, put it in. 1, 2. Compressor, not sense, open fuse.
You know what? I would remove the soft start for right now and see if this, or we could test the open windings on the compressor. Test the windings on the compressor. A la peanut butter sandwiches. A la peanut butter sandwiches. And yet another video where the soft start killed the compressor. Oh, and they're going to be hating. This is number 3. Soft start killed the compressor. Killed the operation of the compressor. Come on. You guys don't like clickbait?